Everyone, and welcome to my channel. Today we are going to be talking about really interesting R packages called BioMart and Annotation Database. With using these two packages, we can convert the gene IDs to gene symbols. The first method is to convert the gene IDs to gene symbols by using the BioMart package. BioMart is a bioinformatics package in R that provides an easy and convenient way to access and retrieve data from various biological databases, such as InSymbol, UniProt, and NCBI. With BioMart, one can access a wide range of data such as gene information, gene expression, variants, protein information, orthologs, and other functional annotations. BioMart also allows users to combine different databases and filter data using various criteria, such as gene IDs or chromosomal location. It is widely used in bioinformatics research and analysis. If you are a biomedical researcher, using BioMart can really enhance your data analysis and give you an edge in your field. Our video will give you an introduction to the packages and also tips on how to get started with them. So stay tuned for more information on how to use BioMart and Annotation Database for your research. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and leave a comment down below on your thoughts on BioMart and Annotation Database. Thanks for watching. Firstly, we upload the packages that we will need to use, such as BioMart and org.hs.eg.db. Then we upload the data file which has the gene IDs that we want to convert to gene symbols with BioMart. As here we can see, we have data frame consists of rows and columns. The first column that we have contains the gene symbol gene IDs. The initial step is to identify the BioMart services that InSymbol presently offers. We may accomplish this by calling the function listInSymbol, which returns a list of all available InSymbol BioMart web services. As here we can see, we have the BioMart and its versions for genes, mouse strains, SNPs, and regulation. Then we run using symbol BioMart equal to genes. We run this code in order to specify the InSymbol database that we will be used. Here, the BioMart argument is set to genes, which means we are interested in gene-related information. As we can see, the database consists of three columns, which are the name, description, and the version of the datasets. Then, the InSymbol equal to use dataset. Dataset equal to HSAMIANS gene InSymbol. MART equal InSymbol. This code creates a dataset object named InSymbol in R. It uses the function useDataset to specify the dataset to use, which is Homo sapiens or HSAMIANS gene InSymbol, and the MART to use, which is InSymbol. The HSAMIANS gene InSymbol dataset is a dataset from InSymbol that contains gene annotation information for the Homo sapiens species. The InSymbol MART is a bioconductor package that provides an interface to the InSymbol database, which allows users to access genomic data in R using functions in the package. Attributes equal to list attributes InSymbol. The attributes define the data that we want to retrieve. For example, we could look up gene symbols or chromosomal coordinates. The list attributes function returns a list of all available attributes in the specified dataset. We have three columns, which are name, description, and page. Name, it has ensemble gene ID, ensemble gene ID version, ensemble transcript ID version, and so on. And for the description regarding the ensemble gene IDs, it has genus table ID. And for the ensemble gene ID version, it has the genus table ID version, and so on. By running the code of use ensemble biomart equal to genes, dataset H. sapiens gene ensemble version 106, we set up a connection to the ensemble database for the human genome version 106 and select the genes dataset. Let's run that code. Lastly, getBM mart equal ensemble attributes equal to HGNC symbol filters equal to ensemble gene ID values equal to data file $ gene IDs. For this code, it uses the getBM function from the biomart library to retrieve HGNC symbols for genes with ensemble gene IDs specified in the gene IDs column of our data named datafile. And then let's check our data after this conversion. As we can see, the gene IDs were all converted to gene symbols. Browse vignettes command allows the user to open and navigate through the package vignettes for biomart, which is useful for learning how to use the package, understanding its features, and exploring the available data sources. The second method to convert the gene IDs to the gene symbols is by using the annotation database. The org.hs.eg.database is a bioconductor package that contains annotation data for the human genome. It provides a connection between gene identifiers and their corresponding gene symbols, gene descriptions, gene ontology terms, and other relevant information. This package is useful for data analysis and annotation in the context of human genetics studies. Firstly, we upload the library. As here we can see, by using the colons function, we have 26 gene forms such as ensemble, samples, and others. The data file to retrieve our data, which has our gene IDs. Here we can see, have rows and columns, and we have the gene IDs column. Data file $ gene IDs equal to map IDs org.hs.eg.db keys equal data file $ gene IDs key type equal ensemble column equal symbol. This code adds a new column named gene IDs to an existing data file. The values in this column are obtained by matching the values in the existing column gene IDs with their corresponding symbols using the org.hs.eg database package. This package contains information about the human genome, including a mapping of ensemble gene IDs to their corresponding gene symbols. The map IDs function from this package is used to perform this mapping with the key type parameter set to ensemble to specify that the input key correspond to ensemble IDs, and the column parameter set to symbol to specify that the output should be gene symbol values. The resulting gene symbol values are then assigned to the new gene IDs column in the original data file. Let's run that code. Let's check the conversion. As we can see, the old gene IDs have converted to gene symbols. not only conversion to gene symbols, but also we can convert the gene IDs to intrace IDs by just making the column equal to intrace. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If yes, then please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, hit the like button, share the video, and leave your comments under the comment section. Until next time, happy analyzing!